Socrates, who you heard about earlier, not Mark Socrates, the other Socrates, Socrates the philosopher, right? So he was one of the people who would walk around Athens and teach the youth, you guys, you kind of your age, about all sorts of philosophical things, all sorts of philosophical questions, and his main method of doing so was questioning people and questioning everything. Up until this point, it was pretty much just accepted that you accepted the truth that you were told. People would lecture to you and that was it. But he encouraged people to question. In fact, when your teachers ask you in class about why you think that's justified, why you think that is right, that's called Socratic questioning, named after Socrates, who was the first to ever use that kind of style of teaching. And he was a teacher. But part of that whole kind of questioning thing meant he got into a bit of trouble, because he taught the youth of Athens to question everything, to question democracy, to question the very gods themselves. And so for that, one day he was arrested and he was brought to this prison here. And he probably stayed in one of these cells behind me. It's difficult to know which one, of course, but this is probably the prison site of where Socrates would have been held. It's just actually outside the Agora, because you can't keep a prison on the site. So it's actually just outside the boundaries. Now, Socrates was put in trial for corrupting the youth of Athens, essentially for encouraging youth to think critically, for teaching young people. And so therefore, obviously, as a teacher, that's kind of pretty close to my heart, because I think that's really a vital part of what we do. He was given a choice in his trial. He could either be banished from Athens forever, or he could die. And he loved Athens so much, he chose to die. He was able to give a defense, or something called an apologia. And in that apology, he said, make sure you go on questioning things. Make sure you carry on not accepting things just as they are. That was his last message. And I'll come back to the final bit of the apologia, as written by Plato, recording his notes in a minute. But he was taken down to this prison, and in this room here, where this very attractive scaffold is right now, that was the execution room. He would have been given a cup of hemlock, a poison, which he would have drunk, and died. His last words of his apologia, as written down by Plato, were this. Now the time has come for us to depart. I go to die and you go to live. Whichever is best is known to nobody except the gods.